How's it going, everyone, and welcome to a brand new start to modded Stardew Valley. So as you know, I posted a video not too long ago saying something about my save file becoming pretty much useless because it went back too far when I had to reinstall Windows. I deleted that video, and the reason I deleted that video is because there's no point in putting that video out. I can just tell you guys now if you didn't get to see it. I had to re-update Windows, reinstall it, all that good stuff, corrupted an SSD, and I had to use a new SSD. It was a pain. It was a major pain. But everything's working. I hope everything got reset for all my settings on my computer. So if the recording's a little botchy or something, I won't post it. And if it's decent, and I think it's decent and sounds decent, I've run some tests, it should work. But I'm hoping it works. If it's decent, I'll post it. If not, well, I'll figure things out from there. But I did install some different mods, a new farm too. We have a different farm. It's Immersive Farm 2 from Stardew Valley Expanded. So it's from the same mod as Grandpa's farm, but it's different. It's a bigger farm, like a really big farm. It has minecarts that go to different places on the farm because it's so big. And there's secrets, lots of secrets, 4 secrets, 5 secrets, I don't remember. But it's a pretty big map. Now, you know what, actually, I could show you what size the map is. All right, give me just a moment. All right, so this is the map we used before. This was Grandpa's map. It's pretty big, right? It's huge. Well, Immersive Farm 2, this is the map we're gonna be using. It's huge, and there's even more areas that are, you know, they're secrets, so we have to find those. Here's what it looks like with no debris. It's really big. So I did get rid of all the fences because I don't really want them. I'll put my own down because I have a fence mod anyways. So I will be changing that up. So yeah, this is the new thing. This is pretty cool, isn't it? Alright, well, enough about that. Let's get back to the game. Give me just a moment. Alright, I'm back in. Now, I did uninstall some mods. As you see, my tools are different, but I did put new ones in, like this. Now the parsnips, all the plants and everything are going to look different. All of them. I don't know if I can show it. Let's see. Better crops and foraging and better gems and minerals. They're awesome. Better artisan goods. There's all kinds of changes I made. I also think I fixed the issues with the textures for Stardew Valley Expanded. There was a little thing I had to fix. It was annoying, but I fixed it. Anyways, let's go ahead and get to the game. Sorry about the little 3-minute rant or talk or whatever. Let's go ahead and begin. Welcome to Kozu 5, your number one source for weather news and entertainment. And now, the weather forecast for tomorrow. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Ooh, I see a glimmer within my scrying orb, a shard of knowledge from the future. The spirits feel neutral today, the day is in your hands. Welcome to Living Off the Land, we're back again with another tip for y'all, now listen up. This one's for all you greenhorns out there. Chop wood and search for wild forage to earn some extra cash while waiting on your first harvest. Alright, good to know. And here we are. Now, thing is, I don't know where to plant anything because it's all grass. Oh, I can just plant them on here. That's a little weird, but I guess it's fine. We're gonna have our first crops over here. Then we'll just plant them. Now, the way I'm gonna make this series is a little different from my other one because we've seen a lot of stuff if you've watched my series. I don't know if you have, but if you have, then you know a lot of the cutscenes already. But I think I'm gonna watch them all again. Just because. And I think I'm gonna skip out on farm work. Like this stuff, I'm gonna skip this stuff out because it's just gonna be repetitive and not very fun. When I harvest wood, I'm gonna skip it out. The mines, I'm gonna keep doing like once in a while. When I complete it is when I'll start skipping, but not all the time. Only when I'm like hunting down certain materials and doing a short quest or something. I don't know. It just depends. It'd be nice if you guys gave me feedback on what you want to see. Anyways, we are done with that. There is one of the areas that lead to a mine shaft here I could show you. Cut that grass. Here it is. You could take these to different parts of the, you know, farm, and there's also stuff like this. I don't know what that is. I don't even know if that's a cave you can enter. That'd be kind of cool. But yeah. Everything seems to be running great, which is awesome. Oh, maybe I could have put them right there. Oh, here we have an event.
Sheesh, Lenny, not too loud now. What if someone heard you? They might find out about me and...
Chill, Lulu. No one cares. Anyways, I gotta go. Still got lots of paperwork left. Real nice of you to saddle me with all that, by the way.
Stop calling me that. And it's your own fault for procrastinating all the time.
No can do, Lulu. It's my right as your big sister. Anyways, gotta go. Gotta catch the cable car before it fills up.
Take care now.
King Lee!
Oh, nice seeing you. So, how much of that did you hear? Lenny. That was Lenny, my older sister. She came by to give me Richside Village's financial report from last year. Richside Village? Oh, your grandpa never told you. There are neighbors in the mountains to the west. You can use the cable car to head up there if you'd like to visit. The cable car is a marvel of engineering. Who knows how they paid for it? I did hear that someone in the village has close ties to the governor. Anyway, do go visit them when you have the time. A part of their tourism revenue goes to Pelican Town, you know. I better get back to town. Goodbye now, Kingly.
Alright. Also, yeah, this is my character. You didn't get to see me make him or anything. But yeah, this is my character. Richside Village, huh? I should visit sometime soon. Also, about who I'm marrying. I'm thinking of marrying Luna, because Luna has a very interesting side quest with her. So I'm thinking of marrying her. If you marry her, her side quest is easier. Her main quest, actually, not side quest, is easier to do. Hola, my name's Carmen. If you need any fishing stuff, I have your back. It's good to know. But yeah, I think it's going to be Luna. It's sad I didn't get to follow through with Sophia, but oh well. I've seen all the events she had, so not that big of a deal. Now, I should go into town to meet and greet, but there's... Oh, here's this. There's a big issue with that. You see, for some reason, it didn't do this last time, but I think it's because I already had the quest completed, so I didn't get to see it. But the game now has a thing, thanks to the mods, to where I have to meet and greet with 68 people instead of the normal. That's because it's adding Stardew Valley Expanded's mods, our characters, and Ridgeside Village's characters, and I believe Luna. So yeah, that's something else. That's gonna be pretty tough. All right, I'm gonna gather enough wood for a chest. I should be able to do it, and I'll see you guys soon. All right, I believe I have enough wood. So as I said before, Stardew Valley Expanded adds a thing to where it costs more for repairing and stuff. I turned it on because it's a challenge and I wanted to. So yeah, we got a new challenge to deal with. Well, we dealt with it before, just, you know, this time we actually have to we actually have to prepare for it because we're at the beginning of the game now. And I don't think I messed with, no, I did mess with it at the beginning of the game last time, didn't I? Huh. Oh, I forgot about that. And there is... What's your name again? Kenneth. I got it right. Hey, you're the new farmer, right? Lenny said you'd likely stop by. Nice to meet you. I'm Kenneth, Ridgeside Village's own electrician. Hope you're doing well. Stop by. We're in the middle of the street. And I got my first artifact. I probably shouldn't be digging up anything. I don't know you. That's a good thing to say. Oh, you're the new farmer. I'm Yuma. Shiro is my big brother. Well, I need to go. Bye.
Oh, hello, sir. I haven't seen you around before. Are you the new farmer who just moved into the valley?
Nice to meet you. I'm Philip. I work as a physician or physical therapist for some individuals in the area. I'll see you around. All right. We already met some of them. See, and I'll show you. Seven. Seven out of 68 people met. Seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Okay, so Lenny counted. And we can go down here to meet Dr. Harvey real quick.
It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Harvey, the local doctor. I perform regular checkups and medical procedures for all the residents of Pelican Town. It's rewarding work. I hope you'll find your own work equally rewarding in time.
Alright. So, the first thing I want to do before anything else is go here and buy some seeds. And also talk to a couple people before they run away.
Why, hello, and welcome to our little community, dear. You can call me Granny if you'd like.
And then we'll talk to Abigail before she gets out of here.
Oh, that's right, I heard someone new was moving into the old farm. It's kind of a shame, really. I always enjoyed exploring those overgrown fields by myself.
Also, Luna's birthday is the 3rd. I have to get her a gift. It's going to be kind of hard to do that, though.
Oh, hello. It's nice to meet you.
I just noticed. Do I have the same hairstyle as her?
Well, you must be Kingly, the new farmer. I'm Caroline.
Kind of.
Yeah, I think I do.
Huh. Oh, well. I like this hairstyle. Alright, so profit margin, I put at 50%. What that means, at least from what I understand, is if you, or when you buy something, it's going to be cheaper, but when you sell something, you're going to get less money. So I put it at 50%. They recommended 50 to 75% because 25% is pretty broken in their opinion, I guess. I'm talking about, you know, guides I looked up. So parsnip seeds are 10 instead of 20. I'm going to go ahead and get those because that's the best thing to plant to get my farming level up right now. And then I want to get some cauliflower seeds as well. And there's all my money. That way I can't... I'm not going to be able to plant them unless I eat something, but...
Oh my, aren't you a cutie. Welcome to the valley, dear. It's so exciting when someone new moves in.
Would you look at that? It's the new farmer everyone has been talking about. Finally moved to the valley, I see. I've been working Fairhaven Farm here for many years. It ain't much, but it's honest work.
And he's not that bad of a guy. But how dare he not like flowers and stuff? Also, is what's his name home? He is. Alright, sweet. We can go ahead and meet him.
Oh, hey there. You're the new owner of Immersive Farm. I'm Victor. It's a pleasure to meet you, Kingly, is it?
Alright, we met him. Now we can leave.
We'll have to go meet Sophia, too. We'll head over this way. I'm going to stop by and talk to Clint, just so we can get him. And then I need to make sure I'm over by Sebastian by 6 o'clock, because he leaves his room by 6:40. Let's go ahead and say hi to Clint.
Hi, I'm Clint.
Nice to meet you, Clint. I'm going to search your trash can. Ooh, nice. I need some energy. Not much, obviously. It's Georgia Cola. You don't really get much from that. Alright, let's go inside. And we get this event.
Abysmal. Not a single piece in the entire collection. What's this? He found something. Let me see it.
I don't know what voice to do for him, really, but this will do.
Remarkable. It's very old. I'd love to study this in greater detail, but it is yours. I've got a favor to ask you. Would you consider donating any new artifacts or minerals that you find? We could make a groundbreaking discovery together. Oh, and who knows, if you keep donating, I might come across some interesting items to send your way. Think about it, will you? If you decide to donate, just bring the objects to the front desk.
Gunther is great. I like Gunther. He's one of my favorites too. Linus, and then Gunther. Krobus is next. Donate to the museum. We'll put this little bad boy over here. And then we got archaeology done. Yay, 250 gold. That's more money. Nice. Alright, we can go by this way and see if there's anything extra this way. There's not. We haven't unlocked this yet, which kind of sucks, but we'll get it eventually. It's a good... This is the best place to have a tree farm at, because it's just a big open area for, you know, gardening, but might as well use it for trees instead. Ooh, mushrooms look nice. Bought horseradish. That's kind of cool. Also, I do want to complete the community center in 1 year. I'm going to try my best. It's pretty tough to do, but I'm going to do what I can. Alright, let's head up here. What'd they do with the trash can?
Am I just missing it? Did they get rid of the trash can? Well, I'll take this. Foraging's the best thing to make money. But yeah, I don't see it. Maybe I'm blind. Maybe it's just somewhere. Also, what's the point of putting a fence right there? Oh, there's Pam. We can meet Pam.
Hey, kid, the name's Pam. Don't be a jerk and we'll get along fine.
Go in here.
Hey, I'm Sam. Good to meet you.
Hi, I haven't seen you before. And Shane won't talk to us because he's busy working.
Welcome to JoJamart. How are you doing today? I don't believe we met. I'm Morris, Joja Customer Satisfaction Representative. When you decide you want to become a Joja member, I'll be delighted to help you make your transition a joyous experience.
Nah, I'm good. Also, Shane's done working.
Shane's hard at work. No, he's leaving.
Oh, that's some bull. Okay, well, he's busy working. We'll go ahead and head up now. Actually, we'll search their trash can. Did I search this? No. So I did now, though. All right, we'll head up here. Let's hope I got my settings correctly for this, because, man, I'm having a blast already. I don't know how I'd be having a blast. Nothing really changed, but I am nonetheless.
Greetings, I'm Demetrius, local scientist and father. Thanks for introducing yourself.
Quite welcome. Now, I'm going to go in your house until like 6:40 and I'll see you soon. Alright. While I wait here and stalk Sebastian, I will be right back. Alright, here he comes.
Oh, you just moved in, right? Cool. Out of all the places you could live, you chose Pelican Town.
Alright, nice meeting you too, Sebastian. I'll talk to you eventually again. Alright, we'll go meet Linus as well. Might as well, since he's up here. We cannot... Now, here's the only problem I have with the added new characters. Is Susan.
A stranger. Hello. Don't mind me, I just live out here alone.
Susan, I cannot talk to her. She is not available until after that's cleared. So... She is one of the many reasons, or one big reason, I cannot complete this, you know, quest now until I greet her. Kind of sucks, but, you know, I guess it's fine. Oh, there's Maru. Might as well say hi to Maru.
Oh, aren't you the one who just moved in?
I'm Maru. I've been looking forward to meeting you. All right.
Now we can stop by the bar and see if there's anyone we could talk to there after I grab these daffodils. Free for the taking. Don't mind if I do.
Alright, this episode, by the way, I think I'm going to do 30 minutes per episode most of the time. This episode is going to be about 30 minutes. And now we can meet Shane. Nice.
I don't know you. Why are you talking to me?
Oh, I can read it on your face. You're going to love it here in Pelican Town. If you're ever looking for something to do in the evening, stop by the saloon. That's where I work.
Well, hello there. I'm Gus, chef and owner of the Star Drop Saloon.
So yeah, 30 minutes pretty much. And the reason I'm saying 30 minutes is I don't want something to happen to where this crashes. It seems the longer I run this, the sooner it crashes, and I don't want that. So I'm going to try my best to skip on things I don't need to, you know, do, but I'm going to keep it relatively, you know, simple on what I do. If that makes any sense. Probably not. But if it does, it does. If it doesn't, it doesn't. Alright, so I need energy, and the best way to get energy is to eat this. But I don't want to eat that. I will eat the daffodils. They give more energy for some odd reason. Or dandelions. I don't know why daffodils give no energy. And we'll eat the mushroom. And then I'll get this. Alright, so I'll be right back as soon as I'm done. Alright, got everything planted and watered. Now, you might be wondering where I'm getting water at. And, I mean, you could see it right there. That's the only place I could find to get water. So, I'm definitely going to have to build a well. But there we go. There's some water. Refilled for in the morning. And we'll go ahead and go to bed. I'm going to go ahead and put this stuff up. I won't need it. And then we can hit the hay. and I'll put the bed right here. Let's go to sleep. Level 1 foraging. Nice. If only I had level 1 farming so I can build a scarecrow right away. Alright, let's check the TV. Rain all day tomorrow. And neutral. Not bad. I keep finding cool stuff, but my backpack is full. Yep, that's the thing for the better backpack from Pierre. And that's Willy. Alright, so I gotta water the crops. I'll be right back. Give me just a moment. Alright, I'm back. And there is Yuma. We'll go ahead and say hi to... Wrong spot. We'll go ahead and say hi to Yuma. There is our first library book. Nice. We can go and view that in the library. I'll read one eventually. But, ooh, we can talk to Floor as well. Oh, this is Kiai, not Yuma. Wrong kid. Sorry about that. Heya, where did you come from? I've never seen you before. I'm Kiai. Come visit my dad's restaurant sometime, okay? I sure will. I have to. I want to meet everyone. Oh, hello. I don't know everyone in the valley, but are you new? It's nice to meet you, Kingly. I just finished graduate school for clinical psychology, and I'm living at a hotel for now. Huh? Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Floor. Nice to meet you. We have a quest. Today is Morris's birthday. Dude, I can't even go to the mines and you're asking for ore? Are you kidding me, Clint? Clint, what's your deal, man? Alright, get away. Kelp. Not the best of things, but kelp's kelp. It's free. Oh, and there's Vincent. Oh, a stranger. My name's Vincent. Mama says not to talk to strangers, but you seem okay. Thank you. It's very nice of you. Alright, we'll go ahead and head down here and see this cutscene. If you guys think I should skip cutscenes that I've already done, let me know. I don't mind viewing them. They're pretty fun to view. They take time up, but...
Ahoy there, son. Heard there was a newcomer in town. Good to finally meet ya. Ah, I'm still trying to unwind from a month out on the salty seas. It was a big haul. I sold lots of good fish. Finally saved enough to buy me a new rod.
His voice is all over the place. Sorry. I'm bad at pirate voice sometimes.
Here, I want you to have my old fishing rod. It's important to me that the art of fishing stays alive, and hey, maybe you'll buy something from the shop once in a while.
My throat hurts so bad. Not really. You received a bamboo pole.
There's good water here in the valley. All kinds of fish. Oh yeah, my shop's back open now, so come by if you need any supplies. I'll also buy anything you catch. If it smells, it sells. That's what my old papa used to say, anyway.
And then that's it for the talking. We'll go ahead and skip. Save a few moments. Alright, we got the fishing rod. Nice. Let's go in here and actually say hi to Willy, because I don't believe he counts. 28.
Ahoy there! It's nice to see young folk moving into the valley. It's not very common these days.
He counted already. Okay. Didn't think he would, but I guess it did. We'll go ahead and collect this stuff, and then we'll head over this way to say hi to Sophia. And then see if Marnie's at her place, and we'll say hi to Marnie, and so on and so forth. Sophia is up here. We'll go ahead and walk this way. Is she outside or is she inside? She is outside. It is the season for her to grow her grapes, so. A stranger! Wait, aren't you Kingly, the new farmer? Sorry, I get a little nervous around people I haven't met before. My name is Sophia. I'm the owner of Blue Moon Vineyard. Alright. But yeah, the textures, it seems to be alright. It's a little weird on the ground, but we'll see if it's fixed. See... In the post for one of the, what was messing up was pastoral colors for Stardew Valley or something like that, or an interior mod. I can't remember which one, but before we go over there and see the truth, there was a post saying that they fixed it and they put the pictures for it in the folder or in a zip file and let people download it. So I downloaded it and it worked. Oh God, it's better now. Oh, that's amazing. I can't believe it. While we're here, though, we can go down here and check for some spring onions. And we're not going to get lucky. There is no spring onions in my future. Oh, well. Go ahead and head up. Growing some strawberries. How dare you grow stuff like that? I want strawberries. Oh, boy. I am so glad the building's fixed. They look ugly. It was my fault all along. It was a mod. Apparently, I should go... If you go to the mod, I'm pretty sure it's Grappleton's Interiors. There is a post with the download link for the fix. You just have to install it in the correct folder, which they will tell you which folder to put it in. And it's as simple as that. But again, all the mods I have in my game will be in the description. And I will put links on the first episode only. I'll put all the mods I have, but links will not be in the description for every other video after this. Because that would seriously be a pain. Anyways, we missed someone to talk to, and that's George.
It's irritating to have to meet all these new people, huh? Name is George, by the way. Now buzz off.
Maybe that was a good old man voice, right? Alright, let's go ahead and head into the store. Okay, well, move, Abigail. There's some people we can go talk to. Ooh, Augur's here.
You must be the new farmer in the area. Kingly, was it? I cannot afford to waste time with pleasantries, and you are wasting my time.
Alright, see you later, Augur. Oh, you aren't exactly how I imagined, but that's okay. I'm Jody. Olivia's concentrating on her yoga form. Don't look, I'm all red and sweaty. My arms are strong, but my legs need work. Exercising can be fun. Forgot it was this day, so. Ah, Mayor Lewis told me you just arrived. I'm Marnie. Alright, I'll leave them be. And we'll head out. I could buy some stuff from Pierre, but, well. I want to... Oh yeah, and there's new seeds. New seeds. They're from one of the mods. So, yeah. I want to buy something to give. I don't know what I can give Luna because... one second. Alright, so I decided that since I can't... Okay, I can't find anything on Luna. There's no Wikipedia for it, so I don't know what gift she likes. It's kind of a letdown, but... Oh well, I'll just have to guess. I gave her a clam, and it was a normal gift, so I now know that. I am gonna head down into this forest area, because there's a bunch of stuff I can get. Now, I know I should have enough time, but I might run out of time and faint. I have no clue. Ooh, wild horseradish. I will get this. How's it going, Andy? Okay, well, he's probably drunk in the woods. We'll leave. Alright, so I'm gonna go over here and get a special weapon. Or actually, you guys, I'll show you where to get it. In the beginning of the game, if you have this mod for Stardew Valley Expanded, it's Stardew Valley Expanded, obviously. But if you have Stardew Valley Expanded, you can head down this way. Get a daffodil, that's the best thing ever. No, you head down this way still. And you keep going down. And it's over here. And there's also some artifacts we can get. I didn't bring me a scythe, which was a mistake, but it'll be fine. There's this. This is an ancient sword, I think it's called. Yeah. Now, that's cool and all, but that's not why we're here. So if we keep going down... I believe it's this way. Yeah, it's over this way. Oh, there's a piece of grass in my way. I believe we have to go this way still. I think I missed it, actually. But I will grab this. Yeah, okay, yeah, we can go... There's another way to get to it, and I'll show you when after I go this way. But if we head down here, it looks like a dead end. But you can go in here and get a very strong weapon at the beginning of the game. It's better than the Rusty Sword. It's 8 to 18 damage, 2 speed, and 1 defense. It's really good at the beginning. So I definitely suggest coming and getting this. And our inventory is full. Let's organize it, actually. But yeah, now we got a weapon. We can clear all this pesky grass. And that was, I had to keep going down from here. It's not really that hard to find. And I believe that's, there's more secrets in this place, but I'm not going to look for them at the moment. I'm running out of time. I'll meet you guys back at the farm. All right, I'm back. Let's go ahead and head inside. I went and chopped some trees down to waste my energy. And I did sell a bunch of stuff to make some money back because I bought a plate of spaghetti because I don't know what else to get her. So I bought the most expensive thing I could afford. And I'm going to give her a day-old plate of spaghetti that I left in my backpack or pocket. Okay, I froze for a minute. It's raining. Alright. Beautiful sunny day tomorrow and mildly perturbed. One second. Alright, so it is raining, so we don't really have to do much for our crops at the moment, and that's great. Now, where is Luna? And yes, it's been 30 minutes, but I'm going to keep going because I just feel like I want to keep going. Luna is nowhere to be seen. Uh-oh. Tell me Luna's not going to appear on her birthday. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Maybe I have to give it time. It is only 6 in the morning. Oh god, I hope she actually shows up. Alright, we're going to head down this way. And you might be wondering what I'm going to use my energy for. I am going to use my energy to unlock this right here. Bam. Yeah, there's secrets this way, but we obviously can't go this way yet, so... Or can we? No, we can't. Alright, so those secrets are going to lay secrets until I can get to them. However, we will go down here and see. Is Luna here yet? She is! Nice! We can go give her a plate of spaghetti. I'm also waiting for the traveling merchant because I'd like to, you know, talk to the traveling merchant. Watch her hate spaghetti. And the traveling merchant, her name is Suki. I remember it. You remembered my birthday. Thank you. This is great. Nice. One heart. This day brings back so many memories to me. All right. Sweet. She actually likes spaghetti. Now, does she like it, love it, hate it? What? Liked. She actually likes spaghetti. Sweet. I made the right choice. We're on the road to victory. All right. So we got a heart with her, which is great. Now we're going to go ahead and go fishing. You heard me right. We're going to fish for the day because I want to upgrade my fishing skills. Also, Clint, this is not going to happen, so I'm sorry. If I kept that, I probably would have got another quest. That was stupid of me, but oh well. Now, there's a couple special things that we can do on our first day of fishing. If we fish here, there's a chance we can catch a catfish, and that's amazing for our first catch because the reason why, the first catch you do... literally cannot be failed. It will not fail you. So we're going to go ahead and try to catch a catfish. That did not go far. I think walk of life is interrupting that. It is not a catfish. I believe this is going to be a smallmouth bass. Well, that sucks. Nope, it's a sunfish. Watch this one be a catfish. Why is it only going so far out? That's kind of weird. Is that walk of life doing that? I wonder. I'm going to fish a couple more times, and then I'm going to go ahead and skip. This might be a smallmouth bass. I'm going to keep one of every fish so I could, you know, complete the community center with them if I need them. Ooh, a silver quality one. Nice. I'm only going to try one more time here, and then I'm going to go to the ocean and fish there. Any moment. Hopefully. Wow. Took an hour. This is the catfish, I believe. No, this ain't the catfish. It is a catfish. Oh, nice. That was actually easier than I thought it would be. Holy crap. I can't believe I got a catfish. That's good money right there. Actually, I'm done fishing here. What am I doing? We are now going to head to the ocean and fish in the ocean for a bit. Because I want to get some fish from a little bit of everywhere for spring fish. And this is one of the best places to do it. So. And we can also grab all these seashells. I don't have room for all these seashells. Ooh, a tribalite. I can go and donate that. I'm going to get rid of this. I know that was wood. I got rid of wood. Oh my. How dare I? I need to fix that, but that's 200 pieces of wood. Actually, let's go get rid of this trilobite real quick. I'll see you guys at the library. Alright, here we are. We're gonna put this right here. Nice. I'll see you guys back at the ocean. Alright, here we are. We're gonna go ahead and see Willy. He should be in his shop. And I'm gonna go ahead and sell him what I have. He'll buy. Nice. Oh, I was gonna save those fish, wasn't I? I just sold my catfish. Crap. Oh well, I can always catch it another time. Unless it doesn't rain at all during the whole spring. That would suck. I need to go catch another catfish. I'm gonna catch one here and then I'm gonna skip. Eventually. Alright, we got that chest. Now all we have to do is catch this fish. Nice. Herring? Okay. Well, I'll see you guys soon. Alright, I am back. I ended up finding some... I need to get my... Oh, I do have my axe. I ended up finding from a chest from fishing rice shoots. That's awesome. I can grow some rice now. That's pretty great for early on. I'm gonna need me some... I'm gonna need my pickaxe. I'm gonna chop this tree down. This is gonna take a minute. Come on. Alright, sweet. When I walk in that, it slows me down. I just noticed that. Alright, so I need my pickaxe. And we'll go over here and not use it right there. I will get rid of that. Break this. Just clear out this area over here, you know? Our first thing of coal, nice. Alright, I'm gonna get rid of this tree. And we don't have to water these rice shoots. That's the great thing about rice shoots, is as long as they're near water, they will continuously grow themselves. They will be automatically watered. It's amazing, isn't it? Rice technology. Almost. We'll break that. And why not? I wish we could break this, but we can't. Alright, that's good enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Nice. And we got that going. Sweet. So we got a little bit of extra stuff going on, you know? Alright, put this stuff up. I need that. I'll put that up, and that up, and that up. I'll be fishing and chopping wood tomorrow, too. I gotta keep productive stuff going. Alright, it's late. We got barely any energy. I'm gonna go ahead and go to sleep. I know I said the episode was only gonna be 30 minutes, but hey, what do you know? I'm almost to 40. Level 1 fishing. Beautiful. Made some money. Nice. Alright. Your progress has been saved. Takes a minute for everything to load in. Alright, the next day. Now, that's going to be it for this episode. I want to explain a few things. My work schedule, as always, is hectic right now, so things have been crazy. My uploading has been all over the place, and I've been pretty much just uploading Stardew Valley.
I apologize about that if anyone watches my other stuff. I have erased some videos from my channel. My time at Portia, Graveyard Keeper, and Littlewood are some of the three I deleted, as well as my... What was it? Story of Seasons, Pioneers of Olive Town. I plan on redoing all those because they were old videos. They were when I barely knew how to do anything. And I figured now that I learned how to record better, I will, you know, do them all over again. Not yet. Not yet, though. I just didn't want people watching them and thinking I was going to continue on those saves when I don't remember where I was at on any of those games. So I might as well start all over. Now, I appreciate all the support you guys have been giving me with, you know, comments, likes, all that stuff. Thank you so much. It means a lot. This is just a hobby. I'll say it again and again. I don't do this for anything else but, a hobby. It gets me into actually enjoying the games I play, because otherwise I'm just sitting here in my room and I get bored with it and I don't have a reason to really play. This gives me joy to record and let people watch what I do. So I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you so very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.